time. Now, you have to define what those steps are, because there's a lot of things that you can do that actually keep you exactly where you are and never let you get anywhere. One of them is to just constantly browse Facebook, but don't really take any true action. Just looking in Facebook or even responding to other people is not necessarily taking action. I even had to look at what my process was and make some changes. One thing I know is that my husband is not a fast mover in the morning. He's changed a lot. He used to be one that got up real early in the morning, but he doesn't anymore. And so because of that, I decided I have to change my routine and actually do an earlier video than I have in the past, so it doesn't get put aside because of his needs later in the day. Now, that doesn't mean I push aside his needs. It means that I have to adjust my business to make it work around the things that I still have to do for other people. And particularly taking care of his needs are going to be important, and I obviously have to do it. So because of that, I have realized that I have to do my videos in the morning while I'm still fresh too. That always helps. And as you can see, there's a little bit of clutter because you know what I'm doing. Also, is I had a storage room down in the basement, and the basement is pretty much gone for me. I can't use it. The reason why is because I have my son who is living with me and helps me out in a lot of ways. And because of that, he and his wife, I have really lost use of the storage room. So yesterday and the day, all last week, I had to go through a whole bunch of boxes of things that I never use anymore. For instance, crafts. I love crafts, but they're very time consuming and they don't earn any money. So obviously that is not a good plan if I'm trying to earn money. So obviously I have to change what I'm doing. And change I will. So my morning video is now going to happen somewhere between 7 and 8:30 every day. And I'm hitting the back end of that, but that is my plan. I need to make a plan that works and helps me build my business the better way. I know that when I do videos and I actually share my thoughts with people, I have a better chance of helping people see what I have that is worth something to them. And for instance, I already did an intro video and an outro video for the purpose of helping me build a brand new website that I'm working on right now. Another thing, I actually gave away all of those handcraft yarn, crochet thread, books, all kinds of things. I gave them away mainly because it was important to me to actually clear that space. We're going to put other things in there like our Christmas decorations. It's always important to have plans and to change your plans and to be okay with things having to be different. I heard something from Eric Worre this morning that's really, I think, going to help me a lot, and that is, there's no such thing as failure or good or bad experiences. There's good experiences and there's learning. So everything that you've done that is not good, that has hurt you in some way or slowed you down or even put you in a total tailspin, look at it as a learning experience instead of just a bad experience. You can dwell on bad all day, but it will get you nowhere. So one step at a time. The first step is to assess where you are and decide what things are not working. Don't throw out what does work, but what is not working, and decide what needs to happen to change that. Because there is a plan that will work for you. You simply have to make a decision to do that. So today I'm not doing any share screen. Today, I'm not going to do a lot of tutorial. I'm just going to bring back to the basics of what needs to happen in your life to help you progress to the success that you want. And one major thing is that you know you cannot do it all at once. You have to choose one step at a time, take that step, and then go from there. So how do you eat an elephant? One bite at a time. Same thing goes with your business. One step at a time. Don't try to do it all at once. Don't try to be the guru when you just barely got started. That's not practical. And it's not believable either. And you know what? That's the most important thing. You cannot try to be something that you are not. Here's what I suggest you decide to be. Be your best you instead of trying to be anyone else, because you are the only one that can be you. One step at a time. Leave some comments underneath my video today. Let me know what you think. I will also leave a link to my blog, which is lyndacromar.com. Let's get in touch and let's get you back on track one step at a time. Bye for now.